Members of Congress expect a long day of bitter debate Wednesday as both houses convene at 1 p.m. to count Electoral College votes and recognize Democrat Joe Biden as the winner of the 2020 presidential election. Though the vote count is usually a short, ceremonial event, objections by Republican allies of President Donald Trump, 13 senators and at least 100 House members, will force representatives to consider each objection and vote to accept or reject them. The contentious session could last late into the night. House Republicans will object to results in six states contested by Trump after the election: Arizona, Georgia, Michigan, Nevada, Pennsylvania, and Wisconsin. Republican senators plan to target Arizona, Georgia, and Pennsylvania. State officials have found no evidence of widespread voter fraud, as Trump claimed. USA Today reported the president and Republican allies filed 62 lawsuits seeking to overturn election results in states Trump lost, according to Mark Elias, a Democratic election lawyer who is tracking the results. 61 of those suits have been dismissed. Biden won the Electoral College vote, 306 to 232. Those numbers are unlikely to change in Wednesday's count, since both houses of Congress must agree to accept objections. Democrats, who control the House of Representatives, and Republican leaders who are against the challenge will not vote to accept. The congressional session is mandated by the Constitution and follows the Electoral Count Act of 1887. How objections are handled in the process: Senate and House members meet in joint session in the House of Representatives chamber. Vice President Mike Pence, President of the Senate, is the presiding officer. Trump tweeted that Pence has the authority to reject fraudulently chosen electors. Legal scholars say the Constitution does not give Pence that power. If Pence can't preside, Senator Chuck Grassley, R. Iowa, the Senate pro tempore, or the longest-serving senator of the majority party, takes over. Two mahogany boxes containing sealed certificates of the electoral votes of each state and the District of Columbia are brought in. The presiding officer opens the certificates by state alphabetical order and gives them to four tellers, officers approved by Senate and House members of both parties. Each chamber appoints two tellers. The tellers read each certificate out loud and record and count votes. The presiding officer asks if there are any objections. Any House or Senate member can object to the vote for any reason. The presiding officer will not respond to the objection unless, if the objection is a joint House-Senate request, the joint session is suspended. The Senate leaves the House chamber and both houses go into separate sessions to debate it. Members who plan to issue objections for these states, debate is limited to 2 hours. Each member may speak only once, for up to 5 minutes. By simple majority, both chambers vote to accept or reject the objection.